Now, when it comes to jazz, one of the instruments that really personifies the sound of jazz is the saxophone. It's that reedy, pleading sound of a saxophone that reaches deep down into your soul and really makes you feel the music. Well, this evening, we're fortunate enough to have a two-time visitor to the Savannah Jazz Festival. We're lucky to have Brian Miller gracing our stage this evening. He's being backed by the Savannah Jazz House Rhythm Section. His performance is sponsored by Jody Jazz. Please welcome Brian Miller.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Thank you, Savannah, for having me back. I really appreciate the opportunity to come back and share with you all. So great to see those of you that are here. So great to know that there's a wide audience listening online. So thank you all for your support. Thank you to the festival. Thank you to this town, this city, for striving and pushing through to get this going and to keep it going. And you know, I'm really grateful to be back here. Thankful to this band that's backing me. How about it? Mr. Kevin Bells on the piano. Mr. Delbert Felix on the bass. And Mr. John Lumpkin on the drums. So I certainly thank them for coming together and playing with me and hopefully making me sound good. I have to get this out the way. Well, not in the way, but out the way. Hello, baby. My wife, Taisha. My three daughters, Tyler, Kyle, and Adrian. I love you all. Thank you all for supporting me.
All right.
So that first composition was entitled All the Things You Are, just a familiar jazz standard. And we're going to continue on. And we're going to bring a good buddy of mine, a friend now for about 5 or 6 years, I think, whom I met at the NAMM show out in Anaheim, California, who also is on the board, I believe, the president of the Savannah Jazz Foundation. So he's the president, and I'm thankful to have him to come up and play, Mr. Howard Paul. And we're gonna continue with another standard that if anyone were to ask me, I love Bird, I love Train, I love Sonny Rollins, I love Sonny Stitt, I love all those guys. The core to my heart breeds Julian Cannonball Adderley. And so we're gonna perform a composition that I fell in love with his solo on, entitled Work Song. Thank you. So much. That was entitled The Work Song. And so I hear him saying he's going to stay for one more, and he is, but I'm just going to change it just a little bit. So I'm going to let Howard take a step down real quick. And but thank you, Howard. How about a hand for Mr. Howard Paul on guitar? And he's right. I had planned it that he'd do two right away, but I just feel something a little different right now. So those of you who may have read up about me or a little bit or something, or just even heard me say it, I don't contribute my talent or my gift to anything that I've done in particular that's so great. I began playing in the church, and it is still very much a part of the fabric that makes me who I am, and I know from whence my help comes, and I believe that my music is just a God-given ability. And I'm thankful for it. It is not something that everyone has, so I don't take it lightly. And I hope it's pleasing and satisfying to the ear of everyone listening at all times, but most of all, I hope it's pleasing to God, for he is the one that's given me my gift. This next composition that we're going to do is simply entitled Yes, God is Real. And this means a little more to me now. On Tuesday, my brother, John Carlos, who's probably watching, he was hit on his motorcycle. And, you know, we were raised in the church, and our mom's a minister, my brother's a minister. And, you know, it's never been something, the grace and favor of God has never been something that we take lightly as a family. But to hear immediately just that someone was hit on a motorcycle, you immediately think the worst. And I'm just happy to be able to say that my brother literally walked away without a single scratch. He walked away without a scratch. Yes, he's stiff, he's sore, but God is healing him even as we speak. But I'm thankful that he, you know, that was Tuesday afternoon, and by Tuesday evening, he was home in his own house resting. And, you know, I was strong the whole time, driving about an hour away to get to him and my sister-in-law at the emergency room. And I was strong the entire time until I got back home in my own bed, and I kissed my wife and said goodnight, and she asked how he was doing. I said, he's good, we'll talk tomorrow. And I laid there after she went back to sleep, and I just had to really try to keep myself together because I was thinking just how quickly, in an instance, that it could have been the other way. And I'm just thankful to God that he's here, that he's hopefully watching, and that he knows I love him. I love my mother, my brother, my sister. You know, I love all of them. But, you know, when you never realize, don't take any moment for granted. Don't take any moment for granted, you know, because that phone call could have been totally different. And I'm just really thankful. So I've put this into the show, and it's simply a hymn that I grew up hearing. And, you know, you think, well, these are the church mothers or my mom around the house, and she's singing this song. And you're just like, oh, God, here we go with another gospel song. But, you know, it's amazing when you grow up and you mature and you learn things and things begin to have meaning. And even just as recent as Tuesday, I know God is real. Thank you. And thank you all for bearing with me. My wife tells me I'm a waterhead. I tell her I'm not. But thank you all so much. This is a Latin composition entitled I'll Remember April. And it's gonna feature unknown to him, our drummer, Mr. John Lumpkin. And we're gonna let him set it up, and then we're gonna play around with it, and hopefully you'll enjoy it. Mr. John Lumpkin on the drums. Thank you. That was I'll Remember April. I failed to mention, and I hate that I did, a young lady that's been one of my greatest supporters. She's a missionary who is going through some health challenges right now. I will not call her name as I didn't get permission to do so, but she knows who she is. And I thank you so much for your support. I thank you for the love that you've shown to me and my music. And I appreciate God for you. And I want you to know I love you. I know she's in the hospital, and I was told she'd be streaming. Her daughter told me she'd be streaming for me. So please, you know who you are. Tell your mom I love her and give her a kiss for me. Thank you.
to last composition is a ballad I wrote for one of the luckiest women in the world. She got to marry me. No, my beautiful wife, Ty, I wrote this ballad a little while ago. And I wondered what I could call it. Like, the name of it is just simply Since I Love You. And, you know, I think about that, and I think of just what marriage is and the compromise and the love and even the struggles that are built into all of that. And I think of that as, you know, I do this or I do that or I don't do this or I don't do that, which works both ways, simply since I love you. So I'm going to dedicate this not only to her, but also to our three beautiful daughters, Tyler, Kyle, and Adrian, since I love you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. That was entitled Since I Love You.
So for our last composition, I think that'll be just about the time that we've been allowed. I'm going to bring up a gentleman that's been very encouraging and supportive in my life over about the last, I'd say about the last 5 or 6 years. And even before that, he didn't know that he was supporting me simply because he didn't know I was playing on his product. But a good friend of mine, a legendary guitarist back home, Mr. Kevin Wilson, advised me that I should come out to the NAMM show and out in Anaheim. That's generally done in every January, the winter NAMM anyway. And he said, come out there, man. You know, people need to hear you. You know, let people hear you and play and, you know, just make some contacts, rub some elbows with some people. And thankfully, this gentleman was at the Jody Jazz booth. And he's based right here out of Savannah. And the mouthpiece that you currently hear me performing on, and the mouthpiece that I've actually played on for about the last 7 or 8 years, actually, was a Jody Jazz mouthpiece. And so I'd like to welcome the gentleman that's partly responsible for me being here. And also, if you like what you hear, give me the credit. If you don't, blame him as his mouthpiece. But Mr. Jody Espina, president of Jody Jazz Saxophone and Clarinet Mouthpieces. I'm honored to be an endorsee. I'm honored to be an endorsee of the company. And he's been very generous and gracious to me in getting me here and also with some other things. So I'm really thankful and appreciative of you, man. And I appreciate your encouragement, even though it comes very harshly. Jody's been telling me, man, do an album. And I'm like, man, it's coming. I don't know when, but it's coming. But I'm thankful for your support, definitely, and very thankful to have you to come up and play on this composition with us. This is gonna be our closer, and it's a jazz standard. It's simply, we're gonna do a blues. Yeah, we're going to do blues. We're going to get it together in just a second. But thank you, Savannah, the festival, the board, all the powers that be. Thank you, the citizens of Savannah, for welcoming me once again. Thank you all for having me back. I don't count it anything other than an honor or privilege to be able to come back just 2 years after my debut down here. So thank you all so much. I love you.
All right. Yeah. Good. Thank you so much, Savannah. Thank you all. Please stick around and enjoy the rest of the acts. God bless. Thank you so much for having me. I'm Brian Miller. Mr. Kevin Bales on the piano. Mr. Delbert Felix on the bass. Mr. John Lumpkin on the drums. My brother from another mother, Mr. Jody Espina, sitting in on saxophone. Mr. Howard Paul that sat in on guitar. Thank you all. God bless.